I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me.
We are gathered in the Oval Office for the National Religious Freedom Day, something very important and very special, and special to me and the people that are gathered around me. This afternoon, we're proudly announcing historic steps to protect the First Amendment right to pray in public schools. So you have the right to pray, and that's a very important and powerful right. There's nothing more important than that, I would say. We're joined by the Secretary of Education, Betsy DeVos, Deputy Attorney General Jeffrey Rosen, and students and advocates from across America. And advocates they were. They've been calling and writing by the thousands, and you're representing that large group of people. In a sacred principle of our republic, that government must never stand between the people and God. Yet in public schools around the country, authorities are stopping students and teachers from praying, sharing their faith, or following their religious beliefs. It is totally unacceptable. You see it on the football field. You see it so many times where they're stopped from praying, and we are doing something to stop that. Tragically, there is a growing totalitarian impulse on the far left that seeks to punish, restrict, and even prohibit religious expression. Something that, if you go back 10 years or 15 years or 20 years, it was unthought of that a thing like that could even happen, that anybody would even think of something like that happening. That is why today my administration is issuing strong new guidance to protect religious liberty in our public schools. The right of students and teachers to freely exercise their faith will always be protected, including the right to pray. So we call this the right to pray. Is that a good idea? But, right? You like that, right? 9 federal agencies are also proposing new rules to roll back discriminatory regulations. So we have rules to roll back discriminatory regulations on religious service organizations. And earlier this afternoon, my White House released a new memo to make sure federal funding is never used to violate the First Amendment, which is a very big deal. With us today is Hannah Allen, a high school freshman from Texas. Hannah, would you tell us what happened at your school with respect to you and prayer?
Thank you. gonna take you far away, so far away. The moon, the stars, Milky Way. Come and take me by the hand. We'll walk through this promised land. I'll show you that my heart is true and make you understand. I'm gonna take you far away, so far away. The moon, the stars, Milky Way. And when the night is through, I'll still be loving you. I'm gonna take you far away, so far away.